friends, in today's video I want to share with you all the tips, peculiarities and interesting things that we've learned about traveling in Italy. We've been staying in Italy for almost 3 months now and we feel like we have quite a lot to tell you.
This video will be especially useful if you're a backpacker and it's your first time in the country. So stay tuned and let's begin. First of all, Italy is very big, or rather say a long country. And there is so much to see in it. You will be fascinated by the amount of wonderful coastline and the beaches, mountain adventures, old history, and overall cultural and traditional heritage is huge.
We spent one of the best summers in our lives there and just had time to visit several regions like Liguria, Toscania, Aosta Valley and South Tyrol. But we still have a lot of places to discover left, and even the summer-long adventure wasn't enough. So count to have a lot of time to explore Italy. Believe us, it is worth it.
Italy shares the borders with 4 countries, France, Switzerland, Austria and Slovenia. We have been at 3 of its borders, except Slovenia. And the most obvious language differences were at the border of Austria, where the majority of people spoke German. And it was a discovery to us. So Italy is very multicultural.
The language most widely spoken, of course, is Italian. But a lot of people can actually speak and understand English. Even in some very remote locations we've been to, there are people like that. Also, we noticed that a lot of information everywhere is doubled in English, so as a tourist, you'll have little trouble to explain yourself. Even in the cases when some elder people didn't speak a word in English, the knowledge of the Spanish language came in handy. We realized that these languages actually share a lot of common words, and if you speak Spanish, you can be understood by Italians. And vice versa, we understood a lot of words and could guess the main idea of what people were talking about thanks to Spanish. So the more languages you speak, the better. It always helps a lot.
We think we can talk about Italian food for hours now, because we're so in love with it. As you may know about us, we like to cook everything ourselves. But in Italy it wasn't always necessary. It is so tasty and filling that you can easily skip your usual meal. Apart from excellent fruit and vegetables, our main food discovery was Italian pastry and baking stuff, like pizza, pasta, focaccia, tortellini, grissini, ravioli, etc., etc. And the list goes on. And plenty of different desserts that we don't even remember the names of and didn't have time to try them all. But what we truly could appreciate and taste a lot is the ice cream. Now we honestly believe that Italian ice cream is the best in the world by how delicious, natural and creamy it is. Our most favorite variety is the cherry ice cream that we couldn't find anywhere else just in Italy. You have to try it. It's so good. Of course, you can gain some extra weight with it easily too, if you take it too seriously.
And overall, everything we tried here was tasting very natural. Even the simple cookies from the supermarket. And there's plenty of choice there. And most importantly, it's not necessary to go to fancy shops for it. All the above mentioned things you can find in the local supermarkets for reasonable prices. And you get an excellent quality products. So from now on, because we're so in love with it, we really need to learn how to bake it ourselves, because we're gonna miss it so much.
Hiking in Italy is very diverse. You can choose from plenty of trails at the coast, in the mountains and in the fields. Italy has it all. We hiked via Francigena through the Tuscany, Cinque Terre and Liguria, and did several hikes in Dolomites and South Tyrol. We feel like the mountains are of course the best destinations to hike, simply because there is so many interesting spots to visit and paths to choose from for any taste and level. We still haven't been to the south of Italy. We want to hike the Amalfi Coast, Sicily and Sardinia. So we'll be back here another time for sure.
The laws about wild camping in Italy are very confusing, and in different provinces they treat it differently. But most of the times it is not allowed, especially in Dolomites, where it is very difficult anyway due to extremely rocky terrain. But we still did it sometimes and just made sure that it's not a private land and the place is secluded enough out of the sight from the car roads. And it worked just fine. Be aware that in some places there is a lot of private land, so pay attention to the signs.
There is a lot of payable things and services for tourists, especially in the heavily touristic places like Cinque Terre and Dolomites. The parking, the tickets can get quite expensive, and only for locals they make some exceptions. This fact may be true for other touristic places in the world, but the thing like payable bathrooms wasn't a little bit too much. Almost every train station we've been to had a payable bathroom. On the beaches, situation is the same, so just something to be aware of.
And in relation to this topic, we wanted to point out that there is a lot of private and closed beaches along the coastline. The entrance is not necessarily payable, but all of the space is occupied by chairs, chaise longues and umbrellas, that are for daily rental. So there is not really the space for you to be. And there are still pieces of coast left for free entrance, but normally it is very small and sometimes it doesn't have a shower in it. Compared to the Spanish beaches, which are all free, here the fact that you don't have this choice is just disappointing.
Public transportation is quite developed in Italy. You can get to most remote locations thanks to it. Buses are the cheapest options as always. The trains are more expensive. Be aware that both buses and trains can arrive late and do regularly. When we had to do quick changes from one train to another, it was simply impossible. Sometimes because 5 to 10 minutes delay. So timetables are approximate and better to avoid planning to take different type of transport in a row.
Also, we want to warn you about the ticket and fine system in trains, which can be different from what you're used to in your country. That was our case when we didn't have time to buy the ticket and just quickly hopped on the train, hoping to buy the ticket on board directly from the conductor. But when he came to check the tickets, he was really mad at us, saying that we can't just sit on the train without a ticket and you have to search for a conductor right away in order to buy it. We didn't know it before because, for example, in Spain, the situation is quite normal when you buy the ticket on board without any problems. So this conductor on Italian train first threatened us with the 100 euros fine. But fortunately, in the end, we were able just to buy the tickets, but still we had to pay a double price for it. So it was the best lesson to us to always buy the tickets in advance, because on board you will always pay extra. With the bus, the situation is similar. It's always better or even necessary to have your tickets in advance, because some of the drivers simply refuse to sell your tickets on board, or it will cost you extra. We had several times when we just stopped the bus and the driver refused to take us without the tickets, which again hadn't ever happened to us in Spain. The tickets can be bought at the bus stations, of course, tobacco shops or tabacherias, how they call it here, and in some tourist offices as well. In some regions like South Tyrol, there are season tickets which allow you to take any public transportation within limited amount of time, which is very convenient and can save you up some money.
Talking about developed road system is convenient as it seems. There is huge downside of it all. It's a bad traffic and a lot of pollution. In comparison to Spain and France, where we lived, it seemed to us there are more roads and thus more cars on them in Italy. Even in the roads seem secondary or dirt roads, there is still quite a lot of traffic on it. And when you're hiking and simply don't have a choice, you have to walk along with cars. Also, speed limit signs usually serve for nothing, as nobody cares much about them.
And because there are so many car roads, the service BlaBlaCar can be a great alternative to a public transport. This is an app that connects drivers and passengers, where you can find a trip to almost anywhere you need to go. We've been using it quite frequently and it's one of the best discoveries of this year too.
Hitchhiking is believed not to be very common in Italy, at least by opinion many locals we met. We personally did it only once, when it was getting dark, and there was no other choice for us. We had luck and one guy picked us up, so we'll guess it will depend on the place you're staying and just pure luck.
Another thing that surprised and amazed us quite a lot in Italy was the amount of inhabitable villages and almost complete lack of neglected places. From the very first day of our hiking, we started meeting small old villages consisting just of three houses that were still full of life. As well as most of the touristic places are full of local people and are not just left for villas and hotels. That is definitely a cultural speciality that made every visit to the villages more cozy and home-like. And we want to end our video by telling you about the Italian people, one of the most important characteristics of every country. To us, they were very reminiscent to Spanish people in many ways. They are very easygoing and always eager to help, literally directing you and almost taking you to the place you need to get. They can spend hours explaining you the directions or anything you need to know, and really try to understand you and your situation, whatever it takes.
These people are very talkative, and thus you can connect to them very easily. But of course they like to talk loudly, expressing all ranges of emotions, very passionately by their voice. And even simple conversation can seem a quarrel sometimes. They like and can cook very well in family, as well as appreciate homemade food. That with so many varieties of good products is no surprise. They have a big family and often gather together for a family dinner, especially on weekends. And simply they are very open and good people, with lots of positive energy, with whom you can become great friends.
And on this positive note, we want to end this video. For us, it was an amazing and fascinating journey in Italy, absolutely unforgettable summer we wish everybody could experience. And hopefully it inspires you to come to Italy as soon as you can and then share your own experience in the comment section below the video. Let us know if there is something you don't agree with or have a different opinion about. We're always open for new information. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel to never miss a new video and hit notification bell as well.
We'll see you very soon here on the channel.
Bye guys!